In this video, we'll cover how to use the Swift add-on for Microsoft Word with the Duxbury Braille Translator. The Swift add-on, or Send Word Immediately to Duxbury for Translation, Swift, is used to complete most of your Braille document formatting inside the familiar Microsoft Word interface. The Duxbury Braille Translator installation does not include the Swift add-on by default. So you're going to want to check and see if you already have Swift installed or if you need to download it. To see if you already have Swift installed, you can open up Microsoft Word and you can go up to your ribbon and look for a tab on the ribbon called Braille. You can see here, I have the Braille tab installed. So this means Swift is already installed on my computer. If you don't have this Braille tab, then you're going to want to go to the Duxbury website and install the Swift plugin. The instructions to complete this process are all written out and linked in the handout below this video. They look something like what you see here on the screen. Before using Swift for the first time, it's necessary to set several options. You can do this by opening up Microsoft Word, locating the Braille tab on the ribbon, and clicking the Setup button. If you've previously accessed the Braille tab, you might not have the setup button. Like me, you might have a button that says Options. Under Options or Setup, you're going to want to make sure that you've selected the BANA user type so that you see all of the BANA controls necessary to format documents to meet the Braille Authority of North America guidelines. All of these other settings you can leave at their defaults, and you can go ahead and click the OK button. Now let's get started. If you look at your handout, page 3, you'll see a section called Creating a Word Document Using the BANA Template. This is where we're going to begin to create our document. You can create a new Word document or open an existing Word document. In this case, I'm using a sample document. I think this might come with Duxbury. I don't remember anymore. I've had it for a while. And it's a quiz on early America. And right now there isn't any formatting in this document. Nothing's centered. Nothing's defined as a heading. There are no other formatting applied to it. So we're going to try to use our Braille tab to apply some formatting to make the document layout easier for our Braille readers to follow. I'm going to go up to the Braille tab on the ribbon. And the first thing I need to do is add the BANA template. So there's a Choose Template Here option. And you'll see different choices. There's eBay, which is the old standard before a UEB, which we don't want. Then you'll see BANA with Nemeth. We don't want that. That's old. You'll see BANA UEB. And then you'll also see BANA UEB with Nemeth. So in this case, we're not doing anything with math. So we could just pick BANA UEB. That's fine. BANA UEB. Okay, and it's going to apply that template to our document. And then now we can go ahead and start applying some formatting to our document using the tools on that tab. So the first thing I have here is the title of the quiz, which is Early America Quiz. I'm just going to go ahead and highlight that. And I will go back up to that tab. And I'm going to go over to the choice that says Headings. And I'm going to go to where it has heading 1. Now, they have different definitions of the headings here. And if you want some detailed explanations of what all the choices are in these menus, you can see where it says Help. If you click on Help, that's going to open up a Help window where it tells you more information about each of these different styles. I'm going to go ahead and pick heading 1. There's also a handout that I will link, another handout, that gives you a basic breakdown of when to use what kind of style. So it'll tell you the different kinds of headings. It'll tell you when to use an exercise style. We're going to go over some of that now, but it's a handout that breaks it down for you. So I suggest probably printing that handout too to use as a reference. Okay, so you can see we've centered the quiz title. Now we've got name and date. So for our student, they're not actually going to be brailing on this piece of paper. This is going to be their braille hard copy or writing on this copy. So I'm going to just go ahead and delete that row. I'll go ahead and get rid of date. All right, and then we have our directions here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight our directions. All right, and then I'm going to go back up to that Braille tab. And because it's directions for the, they call these exercises, okay, the questions are referred to as exercises. I'm going to go over to where it says exercises. Okay, and under that, you'll see we have a choice that says directions. So what that'll do is that will apply the directions style to that block of text. And if you look at your reference sheet where I listed some of the different styles and what they mean, you can see that the direction styles spaces everything over 5 spaces in from the left. So directions are normally in a document that doesn't contain math. They're blocked at 5, 5. They're indented 5 and runovers are at 5. If you're not familiar with indenting and runovers, that's some transcriber lingo. A lot of these terms are transcriber lingo. Go back and watch the presentation on Braille contractions and codes, and then that'll give you a bit of a foundation on transcriber lingo and understanding indent and runover. But basically, indent is how far something is, how many spaces it's in from the left edge, and runover is when it wraps to the next line, how far it's indented. But go watch the other presentation, it'll give you a good foundation on that. All right, so we've got our directions formatted here, and let's go to our first exercise question. So number one, okay, where did the pilgrims plan to land? I'm going to just highlight that. And then I'm going to go back up to my Braille tab, go to exercises. And because that's the question, that's not the multiple choice answers, but that's the actual questions, we format that as an exercise level 1. Okay. So that means you can see that here in the print, it kept it along the left edge. Okay. But what that means is in Braille, it will have it, if you look at your reference sheet, it's blocked at 1, 3. So that means that it starts in cell 1 and anything that runs to a second line will be indented to the third space. Okay. And again, this just helps the Braille reader follow along instead of having everything flushed down the left edge. It helps make things easier to find. It lines things better up better. And it's more, uniform to what they would see in their textbook. So we're going to take our answer choices here now, and we're going to highlight these. Okay, and then we're going to go ahead, we don't want to just get to the end of the first one. Okay, I got those highlighted, and I want to go ahead and I want to format these as an exercise. But level 2, because they're the multiple answer choices. So the questions, if it's a multiple choice, will be level 1. And then the answers will be level 2, because we want those indented underneath the questions. Okay. And then again, when those get transcribed, when we go into Duxbury, it will automatically indent those using the BANA rules, where the answer choices will be blocked at, I believe, 3, 5. So they'll be indented 3 spaces, and any runovers will be in 5 spaces. Okay, so we'll go to our question 2. I'm just going to do the same thing again, highlight the question. All right, and I'm going to go up and make that an exercise level 1. All right, and if you haven't guessed, I'm going to go ahead and highlight the question answer choices, okay? And I'm going to make those an exercise level 2. Okay, and now I've got them highlighted. I'm going to go ahead and make that an exercise level 2. There we go. All right. And we just keep repeating this on down through our questions. You get the idea. So I'm going to go ahead and save it. And in the interest of time, I'm not going to go through all the questions, but I will show you what it looks like. Okay, now we've got all of our styles applied from the Braille tab to the questions in our document. And everything I think is set to go. So I am going to move on to the top of, if you look at your handout, the top of page 4, the next section we're going to do is translating to Braille and embossing. And the first step we need to do is click the Braille tab. And we're going to go ahead and do that. And then we're going to go to the choice that says open in DBT. There is another choice, so it's called Emboss Direct. That will go ahead and immediately send it to your document, but it doesn't give you a chance to check over anything in Duxbury. It just immediately comes out of your embosser. So I like to give it a double check. So I'm going to pick open in DBT. And this is going to launch Duxbury. It's going to import our document all in one step for us, and it's going to show us the print view. And this way we can look at it, make sure we're happy with it. You can see that all of our styles were imported that we added, our Braille styles, into Duxbury, because if I go to the view menu and I look at codes, we can see that the heading 1 codes have been placed around the title. We can see that the directions coding has been placed around directions, exercises around each of the questions, exercise level 2 around the answer choices, et cetera. So I'm going to go ahead and hide those codes again. What's nice is we didn't have to add those all manually into our Duxbury document now. It did that all for us in Word. So now that we have all that formatting applied, we can just go ahead and translate. So I'll do File, Translate. And here's our Braille copy. Okay, and if we look down through this document, we can see that the codes have again been applied here. If I check, I can see that the directions are block indented to 5 spaces, okay, and runovers are in 5. And then again, exercises start in 1 with runovers, if they are needed, in 3. And then the answer choices, you can see, don't begin until cell 3. And if there was a runover, it would be in cell 5. So this helps keep things aligned along the left edge a little bit better for our Braille readers. It helps them distinguish the questions from the answers by putting the correct spacing in that they would normally see in their textbooks. So let's go ahead now, and we could emboss this. We would just go to File, Emboss, select our embosser, which is usually your default, and just say, okay, I'm going to cancel out of that for now because I don't need to emboss this particular moment, but you get the idea. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Tune in for the next video. We're going to continue on with this and do some more complex formatting using the tools in Microsoft Word.